heading out of the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. We'll see how these two teams play in this game as they prepare for the opening kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. They run it left. He's at midfield. Bring him down at the 28-yard line.
That's always a big blow to a defense to give up a long run like that. You'll see a lot of those guys hanging their head.
So it's first and 10 after the big run. For a loss.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. Get to that quickly. He's taken down at the 19-yard line. Well, a new quarterback, but we saw this kid getting reps both in practice and in the pregame walkthrough, so this isn't a big surprise. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. And he's in the end zone. Touchdown. Well, a quarterback just showed us he can beat you with his feet as well as his arm.
And what a dangerous weapon this guy is.
PAT. A four-play, 75-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Well, Brad, right now this offense is hot, and they also took advantage of some mistakes there by the defense.
So the score now, 7-0. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. The Tigers and their ground game's always been sensational. It's not always one guy, Herbie. Sometimes they've got two or three that can carry the load.
And that's what makes it so tough for this defense, is you're not focusing in on just one guy. You're focusing in on really an entire scheme. And because of that diversity, I think it makes it more of a challenge. And you got to be better tacklers in the open field. And I think that's really what they've stressed all week, is tackling and game tackling and getting to the football.
Hard to get to guys and make tackles in space. The halfback picks up a yard.
He got right in there and popped the ball carrier. This senior just doesn't back down from anyone.
From their own 26-yard line, it's second down. Offense lines up in a five-wide set, and a defense anticipating pass here. And he's hit immediately.
There you go. Good read by the quarterback to give the offense a new set of downs. If the defense wants to line up in man, work that slant route until they stop it.
And off up the middle, and he's stuck.
Defense had that one called perfectly. That's a big play on that loss.
Second and 13. Ball on their own 34. Throws it in a hurry. They'll bring him down at about the 47-yard line. Gains his way to the 43-yard line.
To be successful, you've got to be able to come through on third down, and that's just what they did with that big run.
from the 43-yard line. It's first down. He makes his way out to about the 35.
Call it a gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and two.
Play is the cause of the fumble.
The offense put the ball on the ground, but give the defense credit for jumping all over it. I think we saw the effects of what a long drive can do to a defense the last time this offense was out on the field. They took that football and drove the length of the field to put points up on the board. And I think it really started to affect not only just the psyche of this defense, but maybe even the conditioning where they start to get a little bit fatigued.
So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. Still on his feet. And he's tackled at the 25-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. He's taken down at the 22-yard line.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and seven.
Finds his man, and they take him down immediately. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Here's a handoff, left side. Gets to about the 14-yard line. Short gain by the running back, and that's a first down.
Smart run. Maybe it won't look great on the stat sheet, but getting the first is what matters.
The stop at about the 7-yard line. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He's pushed out of bounds at the 1. This game's already shaping up to be a good one as we head to the second quarter. The Tigers with a touchdown lead. To the action now here in the second quarter.
Coming to you, coming to you.
Hey, watch that, watch that.
They're crowding that line of scrimmage.
Down. Back nine.
And they're in. Touchdown. And he converts the extra point. An 8-play, 53-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
This defense has everything. They kind of have that blue-collar, workman-like approach, but they also have a blend of tremendous speed to go along with that work ethic. And the better they play, they seem to feed off of it, and it continues throughout the whole ballgame.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That'll make it second.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Tackle at the 31. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. He scrambled. Brought down around the 35-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 35. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. Around the 44-yard line.
Call it a gain of 4 yards. That'll make it third
down. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. They go with a run, and he's going to be stopped short. Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. To get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it.
No gain on the play. That makes it 7-10.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 20. And he hits him hard at the 22.
Gain of 2 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 8.
Run here, right side. The offense couldn't get anything going that time.
No, they couldn't. They really looked out of sync there, and they're going to have to make some adjustments to come back next time out.
He really got a hold of that one. The Tigers know, I think, that at some point they just have to do what they do, even if it's not working right now. If they can get it going in the second half, it should really improve the ball game and the offense.
Well, the offensive line, I think, also has to be accountable here. We look so much to our star players, and we always want them to put up big numbers. But to me, the two go hand in hand. When a running back's going to have a great game, the offensive line deserves some credit. When a running back's struggling, you got to look at that offensive line and say, fellas, you got to help me out. We're not going to change or deviate from this game plan. We need to be able to change this game around, and it starts up front with the offensive line.
From their own 39-yard line. First down. Fires out to his wideout. So the quarterback completes the slant pattern for about a 9-yard gain.
Well, the receiver does a nice job on his route. And how about the throw by the quarterback? Perfect execution. When those two things are going well, the offense has a good chance of picking up big yards.
Gaining 4 on the play. First down.
Quick out
to his receiver. And down he goes at about the 35.
Number 42 brings him down.
From the 35-yard line. First down.
Watch the pass.
He's under pressure. He's tackled right around the 20.
You've got to play with that kind of purpose to move the ball against this defense.
Well, the Tigers, that's their second of the half. He goes out of bounds at the 12.
That's a gain of 8 on the play. That makes it second and 2.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Trying to get it to the tight end, but it falls to the ground.
The defense does a nice job here of forcing the tight end close enough to the boundary where it's tough for him to have any spacing at all to be able to get a foot down to be able to make that reception.
They go to the ground and he stops short. And the linebacker comes up and makes a big stop.
This is textbook. This is how you're supposed to play against the run.
It's fourth down. They're going to go for the easy three here. The kick is up, and it splits the uprights. They line up to kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. The Tigers are just cruising through this first half, Herbie. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, but still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that it's a four-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry.
Not a lot of success for this offense on their last trip out. Throws complete, big loss. That's a loss of 4 yards.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
We've got a second and 14. Ball on the 21. So we've played two quarters. The Tigers lead it 14-3.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Take a look at both quarterbacks in this game, and neither one of them even has their pants dirty. Nobody's been on the ground here. No pressure generated by the defense, but one of the reasons is because quarterbacks have been able to get rid of the football. Maybe a little help in the secondary to those guys trying to rush the pass.
The guys up front always get the blame, but it really is a business that works hand in hand because you can get a lot of sacks off garbage sacks where it's great coverage down the field, but the quarterback has to hold it for 4 or 5 seconds. But it works the other way around too. If somebody's open every time he pats that football and reaches the top of his drop, I can't get there in time. So the coverage needs to tighten up a little bit, mess up the rhythm, jam the receivers maybe a little bit more. Give me a little bit of time so those big boys up front can get to the quarterback.
That's it for us here in the studio. What are you going to do in the second half while the game's going on?
Yeah, I'm
going
to kick back and watch all these monitors.
We'll keep you up to date on everything going on around the country right now. Time for the second half with Brad and Kirk.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. Gets to about the 24-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He makes his way to about the 32. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Gives it to the back. Tackle made around the 33-yard line. Scrambling. He'll take it himself.
It's a good job of converting on third down with the running game.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 42. It's the tailback. He's taken down at about the 45.
That'll make it second and seven.
Need to get it inside the 48. Fires out quickly, incomplete. That'll make it fourth down, and they're going to have to punt.
The offense really had nowhere to go on that one. The play was very well defended, and now the incompletion will force the fourth down and a punt.
He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. Tackle at the 29-yard line. We're about set to start things up again. Tackle outside after a nice pickup. So it's second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Fakes to the back. Caught, and he's hit immediately.
Gain of one on the play. That makes it third and three.
Off, and he's met immediately.
That brings us fourth and seven.
Booming kick. He'll take 18. He's taken down at the 21. Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here.
Down two possessions, this offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Give to the tailback. Gets to about the 24-yard line.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That makes it second and six.
From their own 24-yard line, second down. He's on the run.
This is a pretty tough guy, and he's a great leader. He's going to do whatever it takes to help his team.
Double tight, guys, double tight. Four down. Mark four. Here we go. Red 18.
Ball's complete, and he stopped immediately.
That's a gain of five on the play. That makes it second and six.
Second down and six. Ball on their own 38. They come out in a five-wide set. Now he tries to buy some time. And he's level at the 36.
That makes it 37.
From their own 36-yard line, third down. And he's taken down right around the 38-yard line. Get this one off, and it's a beauty. He's tackled at the 28-yard line. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. And he's tackled around the 41-yard line.
Sometimes when you've got speed, that's all you need. It's the one thing you just can't defend.
From their own 41-yard line, it's first down. That's a great tackle at the 46-yard line. Not over yet, folks. We head to the fourth quarter. The Tigers in front by 11. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. Work the right side, and there's nothing going there.
Call it a loss of 1 yard on the play. That makes it second and 10.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line. Airing it out long. That close to being intercepted.
Boy, Brad, this guy drops an interception, and what's ironic about that from going to the meetings the other day is that this guy's been telling the coaches he wants to play some wide receiver. You wonder why you're not playing wide receiver? Because you can't catch the ball as a defensive back.
He's in trouble. Good tackle there in space. A little toss across the middle. He made the catch, but he didn't get the first down.
Yeah, right now, the way this defense is swarming, there's just no room for him to get upfield for the first down.
Doesn't want to let the punt returner have a chance here. He just wants to change field position. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. So they're just about set to get the game going again. Excellent open field tackle. From their own 31-yard line, first down. They'll take it inside, but the defense is ready. Pushed out of bounds at the 33 from their own 33-yard line. It's third down. It's a fumble. It's picked up by the defense. That's a big break for this defense.
You know, this offense just can't afford to be getting hit with a turnover bug. They need to hold on to the football.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Brought down right around the 26-yard line.
That's a gain of one on the play. That brings up second and nine.
Second down and nine to go. Ball on the 26. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. There's the strike complete, and he tackles him hard at the 17-yard line.
And that was such a good job of reading the coverage and knowing where his receivers were. Any coach in the country would be thrilled to see that kind of composure, especially on third down.
The 10. They'll bring him down around the 5-yard line.
He got the ball, and he was off like a shot. This guy has some big-time speed.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Feeds it to the back. Touchdown! The ground attack has iced this game with that touchdown. He splits the uprights with the extra point. A five-play, 28-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running backs.
And they can forget about returning this one. The Tigers thought they had the right game plan and the right player to do it. Neither worked out for them.
Yeah, I think the game plan and the star player came into this game with a lot of confidence. What they weren't able to really think about was how good this would be that they were facing today. And today, they just got completely shut down.
Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off.
The defensive coordinator did a great job with the play call there. He put his defense in alignment in a position to be able to make a play on the football. Everything worked perfectly. They just dropped the football. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
Pass incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver. He let that pass get away from him.
I think he's a little bit anxious. He actually looked a little bit too juiced that time, but he'll get the next one.
From their own 25-yard line, it's third down, just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Fires out to his receiver, down the sideline. He'll take it all the way for the touchdown.
Excellent play here by the quarterback, making the proper reads and finding his playmaker for the score. That's a great touchdown, Brad, but what happened to the coverage there by the defense? The defensive coordinator's got to be beside himself. You know, you work all week long on studying the offense and their tendencies, and then to have a mental error and to leave the star receiver open like that for a touchdown? Boy, they've got to regroup.
He's in for the conversion. Have gotten a little more interested.
Brad, this one's not over yet. Watch out now because the momentum has completely shifted.
So now the offense comes back out, hoping for the same success they had on their last drive.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
And he's sacked. The spike will stop the clock.
That'll bring up third and long.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 46. They'll line up with five wide receivers. And they get the sack. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers. Well, that one should do it. A fourth down stop here late in the fourth quarter, and that should be the nail in the coffin in this game. And the defense comes through. They're ready to start another drive, hoping to duplicate the results of the last one, which ended in a touchdown.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against this defense.
Under a minute left in the game. The offense lining up in a victory formation, and he takes a knee. From the 25-yard line, third down. Off and he won't make it. The Tigers, I'm sure, are secure in the knowledge that despite this setback today, they still have one of the best players in the country.
Well, this is a devastating loss, but it's one that they're going to have to put behind them. And as you said, they still have one of the best players in the country. They don't need to deviate their plan. Get back to really what they know, and that's getting the ball to their star player. And next week, I'm sure they'll be fine.
Well, that wraps things up for us. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.